What's going on, people? It's your boy Fuzza here and welcome back to my channel. Today we're back with another Modern Warfare 3 Zombies video for you guys, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you guys the solo method to do the tombstone duplication glitch within Modern Warfare 3 Zombies. Now, since the start of season 2 we actually haven't had a solo method in order to go ahead and duplicate items, but we do now have the method, so I'm going to go ahead and show you guys in today's video. It's really easy to do, it's really simple to do, and all of you will be able to do it without any problems. So as you guys can see right there in my stash, I have 114 items, and do remember that, as you guys will see that increase as we go on in the video. Now, in order to get set up for this glitch, all you guys want to do is pretty much put everything in your backpack that you want to have in your tombstone. So just bring everything that you guys want to duplicate into the game, and obviously guys, you're going to want to use an operator that has a large backpack so you can go ahead and duplicate as much items as possible at once. So just make sure that you are using an operator that does have a large backpack. As well as that, if you guys do have a current tombstone in the map, then you guys don't need to bring in any items. I'm only bringing in items because I don't currently have a tombstone, so I will need to go ahead and set one from fresh. So now, once you guys are in game, all you guys need to make sure that you have is everything that you want to duplicate. Make sure that you have also drank the tombstone perk, so go ahead and find it in the game, or you guys can bring it in with you like I did. And then all you guys want to do after that is head over to the Act 4 portal. Now this is where we're going to be going ahead and killing ourselves to start the duplication process. So from here, all we need to do is go over to the Act 4 portal, start it so that it's actually getting ready to start, but you guys still need to vote. Then head into the water that's right next to you, get to the lowest point of the water possible so that you guys are drowning. And then what you guys need to do is watch that breath bar on the left hand side. As soon as that gets red, you guys need to open up your map and vote to start the Dark Aether portal. What this is going to do, it's going to start the portal, but what's also going to happen is you guys are going to die in the process, and that's going to set your tombstone. If you're on Xbox or PlayStation, you guys are going to want to disconnect when you're going through the portal as always. And if you guys on PC like me, then you just want to go ahead and disconnect on the black screen. So after that happens, obviously your game will close down. Just load back up your game as normal, and once you guys load back up, you will see that all of the items that you just had are still going to be in your backpack. At this point, you guys will see in our stash we still have that 114 like we did at the start of the last game, and we're just going to go ahead and put all of these items in our stash, and now we have 121 items in our stash. But this is also great because now our tombstone is set in the next game. So as you guys can see, when we load into the next game right here, you guys will see your tombstone on the map. Now your tombstone will be in the same location as mine. It will be at the graveyard. So pretty much all you guys need to do is head over to your graveyard to get your tombstone. But then also, whilst you're going to your tombstone, I would highly suggest that you find the location for the tombstone perk, so that once you guys go to your tombstone, get all your money and all of your items, you guys can head straight to the tombstone perk wherever it is around the map. You guys will know the location. Drink that, and then you guys can head straight to the Act 4 portal, and then just keep on rinsing and repeat in the process. Go ahead, start the portal, head straight inside the water, get to the lowest point of the water just so it makes it a little bit easier when you are doing this. Make sure that you do watch the breath on the left hand side. Now your timing doesn't have to be perfect, I repeat, it doesn't have to be perfect, but as soon as it goes red, your breath goes red, you guys want to open up your map and then vote to start the process to go into the Dark Aether or to the Act 4. You guys will die. Sometimes you might die before you actually transfer through. That's okay. As I said, if you're on Xbox or PlayStation, disconnect when you're going through the portal, and if you're on PC, disconnect on the black screen. And just like last game, you guys will have closed down your game, load back up, and then you guys will see in your backpack all of those items that you guys had before you set your tombstone, and your tombstone will still be there the next game at the graveyard. And you guys can keep on rinsing and repeating this process until you guys have 250 items in your stash, and then you guys can just stop doing this process for a little while, and then when you want to do it again, pick it back up and start fresh again. So let me know your thoughts and opinions in the comment section below. If this video was helpful in any shape, way or form, don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Anyways, that's it for me. It's been your boy Fuzz. I'm out. Peace. Take a body's high.